मॉर्निंग क्लास है, लेट्स कंटिन्यू. एग्जाम्पल नंबर 14. द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ 10 आर्टिकल्स इज इक्वल टू द सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ 9 आर्टिकल्स. फाइंड द प्रॉफिट परसेंट. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, इट इज गिवन दैट कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ 10 आर्टिकल्स इज इक्वल टू द सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ 9 आर्टिकल्स. ठीक है. नाउ लेट द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ वन आर्टिकल बी रुपीज वन. सपोज वन आर्टिकल इज फॉर रुपीज वन. द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ वन आर्टिकल इज rupees 1. So the cost price of 10 articles will be rupees 10. Now the question says selling price of 9 articles is equal to the cost price of 10 articles, that is rupees 10. So selling price of 1 article is 10 upon 9, children. Now selling price of 1 article is 10 upon 9 and cost price of 1 article is rupees 1. Obviously, when you will divide this 10 by 9, you will get 1 point something. So, this is bigger than the cost price. Selling price is greater than the cost price. So, profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. That is 10 upon 9 minus 1. That is 1 upon 9. And then profit percent says profit upon CP into 100%. Clear class? The answer is 11 upon 9%. I hope it is clear. Now next is example number 15. A man bought a piece of land for rupees itna. So this is the cost price of the land. He sold 1/3 of this land at a loss of 5%. There was a piece of land and 1/3 total piece was bought of rupees 15,000. 1/3. 1, 2, 3. 1/3 has been sold at a loss of 5%. At what gain percent should he sell the remaining land in order to gain 8% on the whole? So that he gains 8% on the whole transaction. So children, cost price of whole land is na. So total selling price of the whole land should be, if he want to gain 8%, in order to gain 8%, the selling price of the whole land should be 16,200. How? 100 plus profit percent upon 100 into CP. With this formula, we got the selling price of the whole land. Now, this we were talking about the whole land, CP and SP. Now, he has sold 1/3 already and the cost price of 1/3 will be, if 15,000 is for the whole land, then for 1/3 divided by 3. So, 1/3 part of the land is for rupees 5,000 and he has percent. So selling price of it will be 100 minus loss percent upon 100 into cost price. So selling price of this land was 4,750. So now cost price of the remaining land will be, children, 15,000 minus 5,000, because 5,000, 5,000, 5,000. So the cost price of this was 5,000 and total was of 15,000. So subtract this 5,000 from 15,000. So the cost price of the remaining land is rupees 10,000. And similarly, the selling price of the remaining land will be what, children? From this selling price, which should be, we want, in order to gain 8%, the selling price should be this. And already he has sold it for this much. So the remaining land selling price is 16,200 minus 4,750. So the selling price of the remaining land is this much. So now how much is he gaining on the remaining land? Remaining land's cost price is this and remaining land selling price is this. So he is gaining selling price minus cost price. He is gaining 1,450. Now the profit percent, profit upon CP into 100. So profit is this and CP was 10,000 on the remaining land into 100%. So the answer is 14.5%. I hope it is clear to you, children. Fine. Thank you.